And the blast of rain drenched basements and flooded some roads today. News 5's Brian Hamrick takes a look at the damage. It's our number 3 story tonight. Brian?
Yeah, Sheree. Well, this is the Licking River. We've been watching it since last week, especially in places like Falmouth. It's still up. It's still muddy. But today, the bigger threat came from the rain before it ever got to the Licking River.
The other one got
water not only came up on roads, but as the rain kept falling.
Oh, it was hard, real hard. And it wouldn't stop.
It made inroads into more places where water is not welcome, like George Northcutt's place in Falmouth.
It just come here and just floods all the way around the house, you know.
And the problem outside is nothing compared to inside. The water moved like a poltergeist right through the basement wall, more than a foot deep at one point, soaking boxes, baptizing the nativity set.
Got 2 pumps down there now trying to get it out.
But there's nothing you can do. If you want to stay in Falmouth, that's what you got to put up with.
Meanwhile, Independence police responded to a car in the creek here on Cody Road. Fortunately, no one was hurt. And water problems were on the rise in many other places where the only thing people find draining is another experience with high water.
And it wasn't just back roads where they were dealing with this water. At one point, parts of 71 down near the speedway, some lanes were closed there on the interstate. Now keep this in mind, with the ground saturated like this, more rain could cause problems even more quickly. So keep your eye out if we do get more rain. Reporting live, Brian Hamrick, News 5.